Hello and welcome one more time. My name is Alex Centeno, Creative Director here at Mercados. And in this episode, we're going to be taking a look at how to create our own color lookup tables and to automate the process applying those lookup tables with Python, all inside of DaVinci Resolve 18. If you're an editor creating dailies or a social media manager creating short videos, a digital media designer, or even a small business owner that needs to apply the same look to your videos and want to do that seamlessly and efficiently, this video is right for you. So if you're excited, I'm excited. Let's get to this. Alrighty, I am here in DaVinci Resolve, and if we take a look, basically all I have is a clip that I've loaded into my timeline. And we're going to go to my color tab, and from here I'm going to start working on a grade. So just for demonstration purposes, I'm just going to do this with curves. So I'm going to make a little bit of a correction so that it kind of makes our grade obvious, so that when we look at other, when we look to see if it has been applied, then it's obvious to us that indeed it has been successful. But you can of course do this with any grade that you want. One thing to consider though is that anything that I apply generally to the image then is going to be transformed into a lookup table, which is a transformation by numbers. What that means is that if I was to, for example, add a vignette, then a vignette wouldn't be included inside of the color lookup table. So any general applications, so if I'm applying everything to the whole image, if I'm applying a correction to the whole image, then it's included in the LUT. If I'm applying something that is selective, then it won't be applied to the LUT. Basically I have a correction that's making the image pretty much green, and so that would be pretty obvious for us to have it as a color lookup table. But of course I can do anything that I want from here. I'm just going to go ahead and right click on my thumbnail here, and I am going to go to where it says generate LUT, and from here I'm going to select the 65 point cube, and I am going to save it into my desktop. I am going to name it LUT1 and save. Excellent. And the next step is that I am going to position it inside of my color lookup tables folder. And to do that, I'm going to go to the color management in project settings. And from here, I'm going to open my LUT folder. I have a folder inside of that LUT folder that I call Alex Centeno Tests. And here, I'm just going to add my LUT 1 that I just created. I'm going to add it into that folder. This technique happens to work with relative or absolute paths. So you could leave it in the desktop if you want, but it's just better, in my opinion, to add it to the lookup folder so that you don't have to be just trying to see where it is and find it. Once you're done adding it to your LUT folder, then just click where it says update list so that it's updated and DaVinci knows of this new LUT that you've added. Let's go ahead and save that. And then reset. Now, just to test it, what I'm going to do is right click on my node, go to LUT, Alex Centeno Tests, and from here I'm going to click on the LUT number 1. And there it is. So it is working properly. So the first part, which is how do we create our own lookup tables, then we have accomplished that. But the second part, which is cooler even, is how do we apply this automatically using Python? And so that's what we're going to take a look at right now. And so I'm going to bring up my editor, and I have two folders here. Let me explain what Foundation does first so that the tutorial makes more sense. Foundation is what is importing the main APIs of DaVinci Resolve. I can use them for things like inside of my Mac, for example, the OS one, or time to create things with time calculations, or the system itself. But the most important one is the DaVinci Resolve scripting library. But because we always have to do this over and over every time that we are importing anything, then it's better to have a foundation folder or a foundation file so that we take care of this every time. And then in our tutorials or in our files that we're working with, we only have to call once that library that we created called foundation. And then that's it. We don't have to be constantly adding all of the different things. So for example, every time that we want to call something with Python inside of DaVinci Resolve, we've seen in the previous episodes, and if you haven't seen them, I invite you to look at them, but we would have to create the scripting app Resolve, call it Resolve, then create an object for the project manager, the media storage, the project, the media pool, and so on and so forth. All of these is the same over and over. So by just including it in a foundation file, and then when we're just ready to do something with Python inside of DaVinci Resolve, all we have to do is include foundation, and then we're done. We already have our media pool. We already have our project. We have media storage. We have Resolve called. So all of those things are taken care of, so we don't have to be repeating ourselves. All right? So if you don't know what I'm talking about, then I recommend you go back and check out the other two or three tutorials about automation in the beginner's guide for DaVinci Resolve. All right, so that takes care of this line. The second thing is that we're gonna call our current timeline, which is this one. In our case, timeline, the current timeline is timeline number one, which is only one timeline. And the second thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna get item list in track. In other words, is going to grab all the items that are in this particular track. What track? Number one of video. So it's going to go to our timeline. It's going to look at how many video tracks there are. And then the first one of those video timelines is going to grab the items there. In our case, we only have one, but it could be more than one. And so it's going to get a list of all the items in that track, and it's going to return it to item list. So what we're going to do is we're going to iterate with item, and then, well, you don't have to get the name, but you could get the name of the item if you want. And then we're going to set the LUT to that item. So we're iterating through the list, and for each item, we're going to apply the color lookup table. It takes two parameters. The first one is the node number. In this case, since we are going to apply just the LUT and then that's it, like we're going to be using number one, which is node number one. And then we're going to do the relative path from that LUT folder. No front forward slash and the name of our cube file. In my case, it's lot1_1.bconf.cube, but of course, you'll change it to whatever it is that you selected. I put this inside of a folder called Alex Antenna Tests, but just make sure to appropriately name the path to your LUT file. An important thing here is that you can use the absolute path. So if you had left it in your desktop, you could change this to the actual address, full path to your lookup cube file, and that will work too. But if you're doing it relative, like I'm doing here, from the LUT folder inside of DaVinci Resolve, then just make sure to set the path properly, and then I'm printing success in case that this is true or false. But other than that, that's our script. So let's take a look. So I have here my video file, and I am going to go to my terminal, and from here I'm going to call my file. So it's going to be ptutorial.py. Again, p is because in my machine specifically, I have already created a short name for Python, but in your machine, you would probably be doing something like either Python 3 or Python and then tutorial. All right, so I'm going to call Python 3 tutorial.py, and it said true. So let's take a look. I'm going to go here, and sure enough, it actually has created a lookup table in our node. Of course, from here, I could just go ahead and export and deliver. There's a video on that already. So, two things we have accomplished today. The first one is we created our own lookup table with DaVinci Resolve. The second one is that we applied it automatically using the power of Python inside of DaVinci Resolve. This is super powerful because if you take a look, we did that with only a few lines of code. We actually did like, what? Not even 12, because we could get rid of the name and the print success too. So with less than 10 lines of code, we are applying a color lookup table to our video files. And what that means is that if you are, for example, an editor that has to do dailies every single night, and you're having to just basically open the files, apply a lookup table, and then save them again to send them to someone else, then you can just automate that process and not have to even worry about it. So you grade the first one, you create a lookup table from that, and then like you just like apply the lookup table to everything and you'll be done. If you're a social media creator and you want all your videos to look the same, then all you have to do is open the video, apply the lookup table automatically, and then export, and you're done. And I mean, it makes a lot more sense, especially from a branding perspective, because all of your videos are going to look consistent and they're going to communicate the same brand over time. So I hope that this has been helpful. I mean, super, super exciting. If you have any questions, just let us know below in the comments. And don't forget to like this video. If you like it, what happens is that the algorithm will favor it and other people just like you will be able to access it and learn from it. So it's very, very important. Thank you so much for doing that. And if you have someone that you think that would benefit from it, please take a moment to share it. With that in mind, I hope you have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.